Hello, and welcome to this video tutorial covering some of the more advanced features of Epson Easy Interactive Tools, the free software application that comes with your BrightLink interactive display. If you're not familiar with Easy Interactive Tools and haven't already watched our introduction video, I would recommend that you start there before watching this video. In our introductory video, we showed how to use some of the basic features within EIT, such as the pens and the erasers and inserting images. Now let's talk about the settings menu within Easy Interactive Tools. This is where you can set the preferences for the EIT tools, as well as choose where on your computer to save your files. So we're going to come over to the whiteboard. I'm going to start by selecting whiteboard mode. And then here we have our toolbox. So we select the toolbox, and from within the toolbox, you'll see a settings menu. When I select that, this gives us our settings menu. So this is where all the settings are set within Easy Interactive Tools. There's six tabs across the top for different settings. I'll start with what we call the general settings. The toolbar sizes is the first thing you can choose. If you look down here, the toolbar, this is in normal size. You can actually reduce it if you don't want to have a toolbar that appears that large. You also have the ability to set whether the toolbar remains in a horizontal layout or a vertical. There's also the ability to change your spotlight tool. So the spotlight tool defaults to circular. However, you can set it to be a square as well. Just below that, there is a tool for when you're using with PowerPoint that allows you to use drawing tools and annotate on the PowerPoint file as you're presenting it. So that's kind of a quick run through of the general settings. Next, if I jump over to the third tab, I'm going to go out of order. There's the language tab. So depending on what is your primary language, we have support over 20 different languages. And of course, we're using English here today. Then I'm going to jump over to the save settings. And within save settings, you have the ability to save four different types of files. And you could either save them in different locations, or if you choose to, you could put them all in the same place so they're easier to be found. But in any regard, with the annotation mode, so this is when you're using the interactive pen and drawing over content from your PC that's being displayed. So it could be a website, a document, something like that, where you're annotating over that. When you want to save that work, you have the ability to select this button here, and you choose anywhere on your PC where you would like those files to be placed. In a similar way, when you're working within the whiteboard mode, you can save your whiteboard files as well and choose the location for them. So again, you select the drop-down, it tells you, gives you a list of folders you can place where you would like your folders to reside when you're done using them and have saved them. There's also various formats for which you can save your files. So the available file formats are EIT, JPEG, PNG, bitmap, and PDF, or what we call IWB, which is an interactive whiteboard file, which is kind of a common form for saving files that maybe were not created within EIT. I would recommend that you use Easy Interactive Tools extension .EIT. This allows the content to remain dynamic, meaning each time you use the file, you can open it and continue to use it. If you save as a JPEG, a PNG, or a bitmap, those flatten the files and make them static, so you can no longer manipulate the content that is contained in each file. Next, I'm going to go to the camera, and in a similar way, so whether you're using still photos or if you're using recording video with a document camera, an attached document camera, again, you have the ability to save these files wherever you would like to on your PC. Again, I'm kind of partial to putting them all in the same type of location, so my files can be easily found, but if you want to store your video files in one place, static files in another, certainly you can do that. Next on the set of tabs, we have whiteboard mode. And what this has to do with is the slide sorter that shows when you're working within the whiteboard. So if I was to close this for a second, it allows you to choose left or right. So if I come back here and I select my slide sorter, they appear on the left. That is the default setting. If I use the settings menu, I can set it to go on the right side if I prefer that it be over there. Next, I'm going to go back to my settings toolbar. And lastly, we have a tab called Enlarge Screen. And what that means, it's really for extended desktop. So if you have content that you wish to show to the class while having other content on your primary display, you can do that by setting the Enlarge Screen and coming to Secondary Display. When you set that, that's going to allow you to cast the image from your PC to have your extended desktop here while remaining having other content remain on your primary display. So that's just a quick tour of how to work the settings within Easy Interactive Tools. As mentioned in our EIT introduction video, the digital whiteboard provides you with the space for instant whiteboarding or presenting prepared lessons. However, if you're looking to annotate on or capture PC content, you can do this by going to the toolbar and selecting the very first button, which is the EIT mode button. So if I come over here and I select the mode button, I have whiteboard, which is what you see here. And then when I go to show my desktop display, I have the choice of either going into an annotation mode or a mouse mode. I'm going to select mouse mode because I want to be able to manipulate the content. So now I've switched, I've gotten out of the whiteboard, and now I'm showing my PC display. And as I do so, I can use my gestures to advance the screen. I'm doing this because I'm in a mouse mode. If I get to a point where I want to annotate onto the display, I again hit the mode button, I select annotation, and by doing so, my toolbars show up down here. So now I can select that red pen, and if I want it to call something out on the display, I can do so by using the inking tools. Also, I do have a highlighting tool, so if I want to go into highlighter, I can select that, grab a yellow pen, and I can highlight the information that I want to emphasize. At this point, if I want to take this content and put it into the whiteboard, I can do so by using my camera option. So I hit the camera button, and it's going to give me the choice of doing a full screen display or a selected area. So I'm going to do select an area. It opens up this small window, and then I open it to capture the area that I want. Once I've done that, I have the ability to capture this and, oops, I'm going to go up a little bit more, and get this whole image. So then I select camera, and a message pops up saying that the capture is complete. And what that means is it took that shot that I had and it imported it into the whiteboard. So if I use the mode button again, I go back to whiteboard. And here's my whiteboard pages. And if you see, it's added a second page. And now I've imported that content that I captured from my PC and brought it into the digital whiteboard space. Okay, so another function that we have is if we come over to, let's see, annotation mode. I'm gonna clear my annotations for a moment. Ask me if I wanna confirm, is the ability to do extended desktop. Now, I explained this in the initial video, the introductory video. If you go into the whiteboard mode, this is where you would have all your settings for Easy Interactive Tools. So you select the toolbox, you go into settings. So from within the settings window, I can come to the second tab, which says Enlarge Screen. When I choose Enlarge Screen, I want to make sure that this secondary display is activated. That means it's ready to do extended desktop with BrightLink. So now that we've set it up within Easy Interactive Tools, you have to make sure that your PC is also set up for extended desktop. And you do that by the normal method of going into your display settings and selecting that where you can extend your desktop. So in this case, I'm gonna exit out of the whiteboard mode. And here I'm showing some content, which I showed before, which was my web page. So if I come over to my PC, I can then grab the content and slide it onto the whiteboard canvas. So if I select mouse mode, I can then drag this into the field of view and I can maximize it. So now I'm showing my PowerPoint presentation while on my laptop I have other content. So if I come over here and drag it over here, you can see that my web page content is still showing on my laptop PC while my PowerPoint is still showing on this side. So again, if I want to go back, I just bring it back and I maximize it. And there is a very quick and easy demonstration of how to use Extended Desktop with easy interactive tools. And there you have it, a brief tour of the advanced features of easy interactive tools. In addition to this video, there's an EIT quick guide posted on the BrightLink support page, which gives a one-page summary of the EIT toolbar. I recommend that you print this out and keep it handy should you ever need guidance when using your BrightLink. For more extensive information, you can download the EIT user's guide, which is posted to the BrightLink support page where you downloaded the EIT software. Thanks so much for taking the time to view this video, and thank you for choosing Epson.